Hey Notion fans, Ben here from Notion Mastery. Today we're going to be having a quick look at the new merge CSV functionality in Notion, where we can auto-assign relations when we import from CSV files to Notion databases. So let's dive in. So let's take a look at how we import a CSV into Notion and auto-assign relations. To start, I'm going to use an empty page, and inside of this page, I'm going to make another page, and I'm going to use one of Notion's boilerplate templates. We're going to use the projects and tasks template. So I just click get template here, and it injects the task database into that page. I'm going to come back out, and I'm going to turn each of these into an inline database. So we can see above, we've got the task database grouped by project, and we're going to be importing tasks into this database from our spreadsheet software, Google Sheets in this case, with a CSV file that we're going to export from Google Sheets. Over in Google Sheets, we need to set up our CSV file. So I'm going to drag this little horizontal bar here down one to create a header row, which is required by Notion to be able to import via CSV. And for each of the importable properties in Notion, I'm going to create a corresponding header. So that would be task name and due date. And we've also got a project and a priority. I'm going to go ahead and bold these, and maybe I'll swap the background color and the foreground color to make these a little bit more readable as a heading. So maybe my task name is going to be task 1-1, task 1-2, and task 1-3. And Notion likes a ISO 8601 formatted date, so we're going to use those. I'm going to say 2024, February, and today's the 20th. And maybe I'll click this date and drag this column down to create a couple other dates. You'll see that it automatically adds a day to each date as I drag. So now we've got a task with a due date. Now the project column is our relation column, and the way that Notion decides whether to add a relation is whether the project in the projects database is named exactly as the text in this field in the CSV. So let's go back to Notion. And I'm going to add these tasks to sample project performance. So I just need to copy that project name there, and I'm going to add that here and drag it down. And Notion's priority is a select object, and so we can add that as a text field. So we'll just say high, medium, and low, and those should automatically be added to the task when they are created. Now that we've got our CSV, we can download this. So we're going to go to File, Download, and I want to download as comma separated values, or CSV. So I will save this task file locally, replace. Great, now we got that. And now we can import our tasks into our Notion database. So I'm going to open tasks as a full page, and in the top right, I'm going to click the dot, dot, dot menu. And we'll see these two items here, import or sync from and merge with CSV. These are recently renamed, so just be aware. And the icons look slightly different now, but we're going to click merge with CSV to merge our task database together. Let's see here. We'll grab our CSV file, open that up, and it'll do its importing thing. And then if we go back to our main page here, we can see here that tasks 1-1, 1-2, and 1-3 have been imported. They have a due date, which matches the date in our CSV file, and the priority looks like it's been assigned properly. We could also bring the summary in if we wanted to, but I haven't done that for this example. The assignee doesn't seem to be assignable by importing either with an email or a name. It just doesn't pull that up. So those are things that you'll have to do manually afterwards. But you can see here that because our project name was sample project colon performance, it's automatically made that relation for us when we import that data. A couple final things to talk about here when importing. If you want to relate multiple relations at the same time, separate the text entries in your CSV file with a comma, and that will select multiple projects in the examples that we had. The other thing is that this is limited to the initial 1,000 records in the related database. So if you have a ton of records, you might have a problem with importing some of that data accurately past those 1,000 records. But for most cases, you know, if you're importing tasks into a projects database, there's probably not going to be 1,000 projects in your workspace. So this should work just great. Hopefully this mini tutorial has been helpful for you. Make sure to like and subscribe, and we'll catch you next time.